COVID plus a year. So everything I do, I probably won't know proper terminology, but if it works, it works. But I'm cheap. I prefer a free program. So like Blender is free across the board. This one does modeling, animation, scene setting, all that kind of stuff. You can apparently even make VR models. Technically not fully free. You have to apply for a hobbyist license or what they will also call a small business license. I somehow fall under hobbyist because I do not make much money doing this. It's really weird. Their cutoff is $100. So if you make more than $100 doing like 3D modeling stuff, you're not a hobbyist. I'm just like, how does that make me a small business? Java. She's going to show you some of our current models. These are mostly just the smaller stuff I could fit. Yes, this is the stuff I could fit in the car. Actually, I can show you guys some of the other stuff I've worked on. I will give you guys categories, and you can tell me which category you want. Is this turning into like Okay, thank you. That's one thing I hate about doing print, because
Between me and my brother and his stuff, I could probably easily tear apart the supports and give you advice like, these supports didn't work very well. Try tweaking it, please.
Okay, is it because of the internet? Why are you being so messy? I do not want to tell you this. Self-taught. My biggest tool I use on here is the solid and then the drawing tool. I am right here, but somehow it works. Can I get to the peak? I think that will show like one of the more complex models that I did. Or will that mess up? Yeah, that's gonna mess up. So, sorry, the train left the station without me. Right, I'm the stuff I do. So one of my favorite things about Fusion 360 is they do have what they call a drawing feature or sketch feature. So like I will find references of whatever I'm gonna make, smack it into here, and then I will just outline and then draw in all the fancy details. If it's something like a sword that has special engravings, I will do the base drawing with the sword, then I'll do a surface drawing on top of that, where I can draw in the engravings and then make them disappear into the blade.
But it helps.
Yeah, actually, like this guy. So, like, this is the Zenitsu katana I ended up doing. I did the basic model on the blade, then I just put a drawing layer on top of that, drew all of the lightning bolts, which took forever because there are so many lightning bolts on his sword. Then we just indented them into the blade, because I don't feel like putting them on 100%, and I'm lazy. Thankfully, it's worked out pretty well. The only struggle bus we've had on this one is that when we printed it, of course, the support structure decided to fill in all of the gaps, and now they are a little bit of a pain in the ass to remove.
As I'm learning right now, that they are very difficult, especially with this.
Can I have that part?
Yes.
So this is part of the hilt, and the hilt is much more difficult because it's such a funky oval shape for your hand to fit everything. I had to do it in a different direction. So for this one, the model started out going by the side. After I got that part, I ended up having to do, I would add shapes around it, and then I would cut that shape from this shape, modify the inside of the second shape I just made, scale it down just a little bit, and then I would cut that shape in here, just to get all these weird, notchy rope lines. I know I could have just put rope on it like a normal person, but I was that like 3 a.m. I'm just going like, I can do the whole thing. Oh hey, you're moving again. Are you going to function though?
No, you're not. Okay.
Yes, you can do so much stupid. Oh, hello! My pretty much bread and butter on this thing is make shape, modify shape, cut two shapes together. Somehow it works. I have no idea why. If
your
I
Google
need to
Chrome is open.
Which one?
Your Google Chrome is open.
Oh, my Google Chrome is open. So pull off from Genshin Impact currently modeled. Because I got bored. Binge watching, what was it? It was either Pretty Little Liars or Supernatural. It might have been both, just because of how long it took me binging and modeling. Like, out of those, I've only got, like, one of them technically up for doing stuff. Well, I'm not allowed to do guns. I can talk about guns. Lipo! Thank you, Jojo. So, one of the most recent gun projects I am doing is, does anybody know the anime Tenchu Fucking Gutter Belt?
I did not watch it, but I know.
So, one of the characters in there. That both have guns. My favorite one is Scanty Gaiman. Hers are these black gold, really over exaggerated, long pistol looking things. So I was able to recently 3D model those for Colossal Con, and then again for, what was it called? Not Fusion? Fargo? Anime Fargo. And like those ones were mostly a pain in the future because my brain decided I'm even static. Now let's make them move. And that's when you go through like the internal stuff where like you have the handle, you have the clicky click, and then the other click, how you have to make these clicky clicks make the barrel, not barrel, the cylinder spin. Thankfully, there are a lot of people on like Thingiverse and stuff who have pretty decent models that you can look at, and those have helped. There are a lot of other resources out there that you can use, especially in Thingiverse. Cult 3D is another great one. If you're just wanting to like cut off a model from something, you can also do that too. I've met a bunch of people who like they find awesome 3D figure modelers. They will buy the thing, get the permission, cut the weapon off the thing, and just scale that size, and it works actually. It does pretty good because like. Those modelers go freaking ham. They use their sculpting tools to make everything look super fine and detailed. I'm jealous of those guys. I'm not at that level yet. I know Blender and Mesh Mixer have the sculpting capability. The only thing I can do with that so far is like, and that's pretty much the basic of my knowledge there.
He's got three 3D printers at his house.
Damn.
One of them is bigger than the other two. He actually printed out a fit box for his plushie to actually fit on there. And he even painted it himself at his own house. Yeah. But you know, just for the plushie and everything, and he printed one out for my blackjack at my house. So he's been doing that, and he's printed out quite a few different things.
So last January, we ended up having to relocate for a little while temporarily to West Virginia, which meant my printer had to stay. We had to leave my printer here in Wisconsin because the new place is tiny, but since it's temporary, we didn't bring everything we own. So we decided to partner with a guy over there who works with the university's Maker Lab. Walking into that room was like heaven. There were like 10 3D printers, then they had like a laser cutter, and then how many hours this one took, but this was one of the few Genshin models that I've been able to like fully restore in this formatting. I don't know why I said restore, it sounds like such a weird way to say it. I'm sorry, my wording capabilities are going down as the con keeps going.
It's been a while since she's actually done panels, and this is the longest time she has talked, especially because this is her second panel today. So it's like, back. So
I can't talk so good after too long of talking. But like, I started this guy just out with the face of like, it needs to be able to fit in my hand, so how big of a hole can I shove up this thing? Was literally my face thinking. It's like, wait, well, might be better to have it a little bit thicker for some stability. So I ended up going from 1 inch to 2 inches, and it's like, okay, we're gonna draw a giant 1 inch pipe. That's too long, shut it down. Cause especially when you go into this type of sphere, because I'm a weirdo, I like to be accurate to certain eras and time periods in what their weapons are. Spheres of this type in China went over 7 to 8 feet tall, averages around 10, depending on what they're fighting. So eventually I cut it down, and now this one's like 7 foot, which is still way too tall. In my opinion, you can't fit the doorways if you actually build it. But from there, it gave me a pretty good base. I'm like, okay, if I build it this tall, I can shove the pipe at least. Okay, so right up here is about as far as I can shove a pipe up this thing. And then you still have all the extra, not including the length of the pipe. So it technically goes over the 7 foot. But because of how it's built, like this one in particular, I designed to be fully hollow. So like everything just prints in wall structure. You pull out the inside, and then once you have it put together, like I'm weird, I print most of my prints around a 7 to 8 millimeter wall. So they're big holes. But that's also because my brain's like, I need it to be lightweight as possible, so I'm going to need a shell, and then I'm going to fill it with a standing filling. It works! It works really well, everything's lightweight. If I biff somebody with it, it's just like, oh. And it doesn't really hurt unless I actually try. I haven't tried yet, and it's cute. I'm waiting for it. But doing that, it also, like, it helps. And then, on the side for this guy, just to make them look cute. You know those clear rods you can get like anywhere? Just jump those in. You can use a soldering iron on prints I learned recently, and you can cut holes in them. I've also used that on I don't think I have a picture of that. Do we have a picture of my Azonian antlers? I don't know. Hi! Hey, honey, how fast do you think it would be for your computer to download Fusion because this one is trying to kill itself?
An hour and a half.
Damn it.
Nope.
That plan is out the window. I think it's on my Instagram. Wait, hold on. This has Instagram. So, one project I've started, I started this right as COVID started. I started to make journeys for Pokemon. Originally, it was just going to be like something small. Then one of my friends was like, hold on, if you make that Pokemon, I'll make this legendary Pokemon. And we can do a group. And then it spread. And then like all of a sudden, like, tons of my friends working on this. And they're like, we're going to do this giant group. And it's going to be fancy AF. And then it's like, now I can't make it simple anymore. At that time, I already finished modeling out the antlers. And I was like, you guys are going to screw me over, aren't you? Because I'm going to be the only one to finish. I was the only one to finish. I'm still the only one who's finished. But because they were like, yeah, we can enter this contest together, and it's so cool, my brain was like, we can't go small anymore. You have to make these antlers big. So they did. And they are way too big. I cannot fit through doorways. If I need to go through a door, I need to bend my head down, go around, and then go around the other way, just so my antlers do not clip parts of the door. But it's worth it because they also glow and they light it up and they all fancy AF and everything glows. But it's working on the I do have an AF. goals that are school.
Yeah.
You have a nice
very last one.
Oh, maybe last one. Thank you. Oh, okay, so I have to do this. I have glow and trim because I became obsessed with glows and electronics for this project. Even though I'm not that good. this for the end of my existence, and then I get close to the end of my existence, and then they stop me.
Yeah.
best thing I've ever done, so it's just the fucking porn and everything. It's just like, I should make it.
It's so funny how people every funny just reach out over a
right? She has stripes.
Braces.
The only thing is this one that wasn't the shapes on shapes is the gem down here. And that is actually, so the initial drawing sketch for the stone started with over 500 individual lines to make it the oval shape. And the only reason I did that is because then once I did make the entire shape, I could fill it in. Shield looking thing in the very front of it, and my brain just going like, brain just goes, where am I supposed to put my arrow? What does my arrow go through? There's nothing here for it to go through. If I add a hole, am I technically being mean to the designers, or am I just being realistic and all this other jazz? And then it's just like,
The other thing for me too, I'm also looking at an archer, like looking at some like video games and models. I'm like, how do you, where does this arrow go?
That I can complain about on this one, because I did not know how to do the shield for like 2 months until I finally figured it out when I was making my shows.
And
that was long. Like, eventually I had to figure out, like, okay, we'll just make multiple things, we'll just keep stacking until it looks right, and finally it looked right. Like, never touching this again. As soon as I finish all these, they go to read only, just so I can't accidentally do something. So, you guys know Viego from League of Legends with his white hander? I think that was so I hope that was. It seems to be cooperating. So, that's a good sign. We can only have like 20 minutes left, and then we can do a lot of modeling. Okay, so I apparently don't have the sword on here, but I can show the scissors. Not the sword, the end of the. Sword has like it has channels so you can put the metal rods through, gives it a support structure, but it also has areas where you can put through ends. And that was the most painful part of that one because like you have to figure out how thick are these ends, how much wiggle room do they need, how much is going into wires, just putting all that stuff together. And it gets to be a pain. Then after that, the same person was like, can you also make me these scissors? I'm still working on these scissors. Thankfully, he doesn't have a time frame. He's just like, I think it's like been done by 23. So it's like, I have time. And these scissors and all this stuff aren't staying. The scissors alone are planned to be possibly 8.5 feet tall. It depends on the model. Because, like, this friend of mine is 6'5", close to 6'7". And it's just kind of like, why do you do this to me? Because you're so tall. It's like, well, I want it to look proportional. It's like, I think going through the sword just to print that one alone, we went through 520K G spools of filament. And that's including multiple failures. As long as, I think it was in the very middle part where like everything connects. It's got a lot of funky shapes, kind of like on this one, just right here in the middle. So this area needs to be especially supported, and if it doesn't support right in even one spot, it feels the entire frame. And this part alone for the swine hander had a 36-hour print time. So it could get all the way to like 24 hours, and fail. And then I just have a giant spool of spaghetti. It sucks. The overlap is like even the slumber crown on the right, the unpainted one. That's actually one of my technically this one is a failed print. So show it from the side. Originally I made it with a little ear tab, but then part of the ear tabs for some reason every time it's been printed, it's got this funky line. I've redone this model 4 or 5 times. Every time I printed it, it's come out with that funky line. Yeah, that. It comes out with this funky line. I still have no idea why. And this is like my classic print setting. So every time I pull off the rest of the support structure, usually those tabs come off. That is the only one that kept a tab out of every single one I printed. So I have a pile of crowns in my trash can. And it's just kind of sitting there. FT5 from Folger Tech. Decent printer, just that one is one of those build-it-yourself kits. So that be my first printer, I said I wanted to die. Because, what, did it take us 3 or 4 months to build that thing?
About. It took us so many attempts when we first put out a box. It's just like, okay, we can do it. Oh, no, we
can't
do this.
It didn't come with instructions. After that, like, we finally got working. Then I got a CR10. Kept that one for a little while, then eventually I got the FP5 working at a better capacity, and I like the FP5 because it is very, very big. I think the max size on that was around 18-inch prints. Granted, I never actually used it for that large of prints, because I didn't know what I was doing at the time until recently for modeling and structuring. So that kind of just ended up getting, like, shoved to the side, and then we got not the pro version, just the classic version, so it's a little bit smaller. But that one has actually been my workhorse. That one's the one that's done all of the prints running up here, while the FT5 is currently sitting just unused back there. Oh, yeah. That is a. Yeah, I don't remember how many. Was on the FT5, which was the first successful print I did. After that, I couldn't get a good print for 2 months, which is why we had to take it back to work. I'd say if you're going to start, try the Reality or the Enders, just because they're very good workhorses off the gate. Yeah, over time, you're going to want to add modifications and stuff. I haven't touched that yet because I'm not really good at technology. Majority of cutting programs and printing programs run on the metric system, so you've got to learn metric. Like, one of the first folders I did 3D modeling was because, you know, I have an imperial brain, everything must be in inches and feet. I would model my stuff in inches and feet, and then once you put it into your cutting and printing slicers, it would be like, oh, so it's this many inches, but now we're just taking the number, moving it in front of centimeter or millimeter, and then just all the time. I eventually learned a lot, like this program, if I for actually exporting things, right click on the body option, it will give you the save to or export. Whatever thing it wants to give you for that day, that's the terminology. And then it lets you pick what you're seeing.
Oh, yeah, that's
horrible. And that is saved by the eye. So I can still model in inches and feet, but I think it was in the
I know right now the main one I'm struggling with is Sombra.
one on the paint one is 15% proof that actually, so I think I'm gonna test that one and like swap it for more. I think I can see my car from here.
I know.